What would it look like?
You'd be able to sit right here. You'd be about that tall.
And
he's feather.
Feather.
Yeah.
Brightening?
Maybe good, yeah. But he'd be very vibrant color, whatever it was.
I think you're describing a parrot.
But a parrot is a dinosaur. Oh, man!
Walked right into that one. I think Jurassic Park is a great example of taking what we know at the time scientifically and just extrapolating that into a fun story. Like you said, getting dinosaur DNA, which I believe has a half-life, so how long it takes for half of it to degrade into unusable bits. There's only a handful of 1,000 years to get an animal back 65 million years ago. There'd be almost nothing usable left.
Right.
But we went from there and made an awesome franchise out of it.
Exactly.
What was the best moment for you working on something like this? Was it seeing the reception? Was it knowing that science could be in these movies?
Well, you know, I think all of us have all of us have dreamed about, you know, seeing a dinosaur, and you know, it was cool to see the artists, you know, render dinosaurs. It's like these dioramas where we see, you know, all these animals here. I mean, the movies bring us closer and closer to seeing dinosaurs in the flesh, alive.
Yeah.
And until we can genetically build them, the movies are the best we have.
And I think they single-handedly create paleontologists.
They do, but before Jurassic Park came out, I had very few graduate students, and after they came out, I had like 18 of them. They're graduate students all over the place.
If I can find the next big thing, I'll make it into a movie.
That'd be awesome. So,